An I-team hidden camera rolling, following these trash collectors. Do they have a dirty little secret? Notice they dump regular trash out of the dark green cans, then they dump the light green cans used for recycling, dump it all in the back of the same truck.
They're dumping the regular trash in, and then they're dumping the recyclables in, and I'm thinking, what?
In recent months, some folks living here have seen the same thing we captured, cans for trash and recycling dumped together, even with furniture. Here, as the garbage truck swallowed that, notice a worker takes a bag out of a recycling can and tosses that in too. Look, the I-team walked up to have a little chat with these guys just as they emptied another recycling can where they emptied all of the other trash. This crew works for a private company, Kimball, and Kimball has a contract paid with tax dollars to pick up trash and recycling for the city of Barberton. You're dumping loads of trash, furniture, right, and recycling all in the same spot.
I put the green cans in, the dark cans when it's trash. We come back when we get the recycling.
I just watched you put them both in.
You didn't watch me do anything.
I just watched you two guys.
I saw it go on and I'm like, why are they taking the recyclables with the trash?
Rafe Cantor shot this cell phone video, says he called the company over and over, got nowhere. So he turned to the I-team to get to the bottom of it.
It's more about what's right. You know, one, they're getting paid to do their job. They should do it correctly.
Garbage is garbage.
Back on the street, this worker tried to tell me the trash and recycling still get sorted even after getting dumped together in this truck. Are you trying to tell me that they separate this at the dump?
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they actually do.
After you crush it like that?
Yeah, when we crushing this stuff, yeah, they separate the recycling.
This crew also then said it only dumps recycling cans with the garbage if there is trash in the recycling cans. But we checked back a couple of blocks, found virtually every can empty. So that crew wants you to believe virtually every resident fills nearly every recycling can with trash. Yet we saw another Kimball truck collecting recycling and separating it just as you'd expect.
So it looks like you're cutting corners.
No, we're not cutting corners.
I wanted to see if there's somebody in management we could speak with.
The I-team went to a Kimball regional office. We also took our video to Barberton City Hall.
I saw them putting the recycling cans in the back of the truck, the same place where they put the regular trash.
I will give them a call, you know, as soon as you leave my office.
The company's corporate headquarters told us that worker was wrong. If recycling gets dumped with garbage, it does not get separated later. The company says it has had a problem with customers putting trash in recycling bins, even toys and shingles and hoses and Christmas lights. Nonetheless, a vice president said, quote, my management team has gone ahead and talked to our drivers. There's been some confusion. The company now reminding its crews if they find junk or trash in a recycling bin, they should put one of these tags on it, a tag telling the customer what needs to come out of the bin. And the company admits that's something that should have been happening before. And a lawyer for Kimball sent a statement saying the company is committed to recycling. Kimball has been working throughout the state to educate people about the need for clean recyclables, and the issue is not isolated to Kimball, but is a national crisis.
I think, well, if it helps the environment.
Bonnie Petrie and her daughter say they do their part to recycle and help the environment, and that shouldn't go to waste. The city of Barberton sent a statement to the I-team thanking us for putting a spotlight on this, saying the city is talking with the company. Meantime, the citizen who had spotted this and complained before now hopes to see change.
Do you believe him?
I hope so, now that you guys are involved.
Ed Gallick, Fox 8, I-team.